Good afternoon. Welcome to the parish community of Mary, Mother of God. We would especially like to welcome all of our new parishioners and all of those visiting with us this weekend. Today we celebrate the third Sunday in Ordinary Time. We begin our celebration in song. Please join in singing number 317, All Are Welcome, hymn number 317 in your Breaking Bread. Please rise and join in singing.
Please turn to 421, 421.
People of God, praise in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May our Lord be with you. Let each of us, as we begin our worship, call to mind our unworthiness, but God's great forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you came to gather all the nations into the peace of your Father's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Come now in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. He'll come again in glory with salvation for your people at the end of time. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth. praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God.
Almighty and ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your only beloved Son, we may abound in good works. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. First, the Lord degraded the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, but in the end, he has glorified the seaward road, the land west of the Jordan, the district of the Gentiles. Anguish has taken wing, dispelled is darkness, for there is no gloom where but now there was distress. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree in what you say, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be united in the same mind and in the same purpose. For it has been reported to me about you, my brothers and sisters, by Chloe's people, that there are rivalries among you. I mean that each of you is saying, I belong to Paul, or I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Cephas, or I belong to Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were you baptized in the name of Paul? For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, and not with the wisdom of human eloquence, so that the cross of Christ might not be emptied of its meaning. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
May our Lord be with you.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus heard that John had been arrested. He withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and went to live in Capernaum by the sea, in the region of Zebulun and Naphtali, that what had been said to Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun and of Naphtali, the way to the sea, beyond the Jordan River, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light. And those dwelling in land overshadowed by death, light has arisen. From that time on, Jesus began to preach, saying, "Repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand." As he was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. He said to them, "Come after me, I'll make you fishers of men." At once they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there and he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, mending the nets. He called them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. He went around all of Galilee, teaching in the synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, curing every disease and illness among the people. The gospel of the Lord. On Monday, having watched the youth group make sandwiches for the people down at the soup kitchen in Philadelphia, we went to the soup kitchen, and it's a day off, obviously, and holiday, and we delivered the sandwiches, did some things we had to do at the soup kitchen, and then we had a little bit of free time. Now it's a holiday. Now, I've been to Disney World, where you spend well over $100 just to walk in the door. But when we left the soup kitchen, we went to what is called the Eastern State Penitentiary, which closed in 1970. Easily the best tourist attraction I have ever seen, and it was free. Disney isn't free. I would go back there tonight and spend the night. Now, it closed when I was 14, but it looks just like it did the day they closed it. The cot's still sitting there. There's the toilet, every room with the toilet. Some with two people house hundreds at any given time, double-decker rooms. The despair and the lifelessness of this cold, forbidding, I thought the seminary was bad. This was worse. Hundreds of people living through this, many of whom lived in solitary confinement, the hole, which you can't go down to the hole. You can see it, but they don't let you down there. But, I mean, it's hard to describe. I've visited hundreds of people in jail, but you never get into the jail. You just meet them in a greeting area. This was insane. And suicide, a constant threat for those who are going to live the rest of their life there anyway. So what's the purpose of living? And escape always. Do you see guys dug holes? That hole is still there. And it was free because it was a holiday. I could have stayed all night. About 7 units, each about as long as this church. Each side, double decker. 7 units. Hundreds of people. Hundreds of people. Of all the placards that you would see describing life in prison, only one showed people with a smile. You know what it was? When they were in church or temple. You see, like, the Bishop of Philadelphia stopped to do the Mass once a year or something, and the Catholic population, some of them, would attend. You could see them actually smiling. The Jewish synagogue, call it what you want, doing some readings from the Old Testament, you could see the people smiling. That's still there. Only faith brought hope, light,
joy. The next morning, at 9 o'clock, the phone rang for one of our local nursing homes. I will not mention which one. It has 7 units. Each unit is about as long as this church. Every room has 2 people in a room that I know of. And I was called to the Alzheimer's unit to give the last rites. Now, that's always the worst unit, okay? It just is. You have to have a key to get off, or else the person will be found wandering dead. And as soon as you get off the elevator, nurse, I don't want to be here. Get me out of here. And they look at you. Can you take me home with you? Well, I can't take you home with you. I can't do that. They're just sad places. I think there's 6 or 7 units, and they're just as long as the prison halls were. And they're all 2 to a room. The prison, some were 2 to a room. I remember thinking, there's not that much difference. But as I was waiting to get on the elevator, and you have to wait because you have to use a key to get on it, there was a guy older than me, much older than me, pushing a wheelchair. And I had seen him. It might take 10, 15 minutes to do last rites. I had seen him walk past the room I was in a handful of times, moving pretty quickly. He was having fun. And so was she. In a place where there's just no life, you actually saw joy from one person. So I'm waiting to get on the elevator. It takes 2 or 3 minutes. You got a timer, you have to know when the food's being delivered. And I didn't do that. And I said to the guy, you know, you're having fun. He said, it's my bride. And he continued by me. They were probably married 60, 70 years ago. You know, I don't think she knows who she is. Most of those people on the Alzheimer's unit don't. There is no cure. But he knew who she was, his bride. And he knew who he was, her husband for life, even on the Alzheimer's unit. And he was smiling. At the prison, it was faith that brought some joy, at least for a little while. And in the nursing home, it was his love, lived through a lifetime, that brought some joy into a truly lifeless floor. There's only so many nurses and an awful lot of people. Nurse. You know, see what love and faith can do? See what love and faith can do? And when you put love and faith together, you have hope. You have hope. When Jesus says, repent. Well, most of us are not bad sinners, so we probably wouldn't be in church. You know what the repentance everybody has to make is to repent from the belief that you can't make a difference. You can make a difference. That man at that nursing home made a difference. He made a difference to me. The priest down at the Philadelphia celebrated Mass, I do a billion. That guy made a difference. We both can make a difference. Do we know what a difference we make? And do we make all the difference we could? That's where our repentance has to happen. Let us stand, my friends, and we'll profess our faith in Almighty God.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father, for all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He'll come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We put our prayers before Almighty God.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. That the church continue to reveal the merciful faith of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in authority treat citizens justly and be mindful of their dignity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who gather here will be nourished by God's love, mindful that Christ is calling us to holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all first responders in our military and those doing dangerous jobs, may the Holy Spirit guide them and protect them daily, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and their caregivers who see God's face in one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Kathy Gilgallen, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they be with Jesus in heaven forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us end the petitions by praying the vision prayer.
Jesus, we are your people. We praise you as Savior and Lord. Deepen our commitment to you, your church, and each other. Let us all share more actively in spreading the good news of God present among us. Help us reach out to those who have not yet experienced the joy of participating in parish life. Inspire us to seek justice and peace for all members of our parish family and beyond. Assist us in living your gospel of compassion and love in service to those in need. Mindful of our many blessings, we are especially grateful for your gift of our parish family, family dedicated to Mary, Mother of God, your spouse, Joseph, and our beloved saints, Anthony, Vincent, Stanislaus, and Stephen. Lord, send us your spirit. Make us alive as we have never been. Let us celebrate together and place our hope in you. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray. In sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. And it is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You so love the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, that you might love in us what you loved in your Son. By his obedience we have been restored to those gifts of grace that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so with the angels and saints we join in an unending hymn of your praise. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. It was at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, he took a chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from ever evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace to the Lord be with you always. We share a sign of Christ's peace. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So by way of announcement, if you gave us a picture or if you had a picture taken of you that beautifully decorated the back wall of the church for Christmas, they're in the back alphabetically, and please take them. I mean, we can't save them for another year. And maybe take it home and use it for your Christmas picture or something next year. I think our church was beautifully decorated. Awful lot of work from the back and the front goes into that. So, just, you know, the holidays are such, just a busy time. And then just weeks we'll be into Lent. And then summer kind of slows. We've been mostly busy with very big funerals lately. As some of you know, it's just been a crazy time here. But that's why we're here, is to serve you. So hopefully we do that well. Let us all stand to pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in the gift of your love. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be with you. Mighty God bless us, our families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our liturgy ends, we go in peace, glorifying God with our lives. Thanks be to God.